Few places in the Midwest rival Indiana Dunes country for great birding. More than 350 bird species live or migrate through here, winging their way across our open waters and landscapes of beaches, dunes, woodlands, wetlands, and prairie.
You have a wide variety of habitats, so hopefully you're going to see different kinds of birds in each of those.
Yes. I've birded on 6 continents, and in my birding experience, birding in the Indiana Dunes is definitely the creme de la creme.
Noted bird expert Ken Brock has authored the area's definitive guide to birding.
The Dunes area is a birding treasure. The state park, the dunes, and the Great Marsh are really spectacular places for birds. I do know a lot of people that come from miles away and enjoy it.
I had no idea what to expect.
We've seen a kingfisher, blue-winged teals,
Flickers. One of the things with birding is it's always fun to explore new places, and this is very accessible.
The reason the Dunes area is such an amazing birding site is because we've got a prime location on the southern tip of Lake Michigan. We're located right at the crossroads of many of the major migratory paths.
Lake Michigan has a funneling effect that allows these birds to just kind of pour in the fall as they follow the lakeshore. They end up here at Indiana Dunes for us to be able to see.
Every season brings new and different birding adventures to the Indiana Dunes, so there's always a birding program or two going on at the state park. One of our most popular birding programs is the Saw-Whet Owl Banding Program. On designated nights, the public are invited to the Nature Center to watch owls be measured, weighed, and banded. When you're ready to spread your wings and take off on your own, don't forget to bring these essential birding items.
You have to have binoculars. Those are a must if you're going to see birds. Having a telescope also helps a lot. A field guide if you're a newer birder.
It'll guide you to more than 50 sites that showcase our region's greatest natural and cultural treasures, including spectacular birding sites like the Jasper Pulaski Fish and Wildlife Area, where you can witness one of the most highly anticipated migrations in the area, the fall arrival of the sandhill cranes.
And there, where you can see 20,000 of them, and as they all gather, social birds out in that field, you'll see them giving some of their dances, kind of jumping in the air, they're interacting with each other, and as they're done socializing in that field, just as you probably get the right levels of light, just as it's getting dark, they will all pick up and move to the wetland.
It's uncomparable to anywhere else to see this many birds of this kind in one spot. Anybody who gets the chance should come out here and check this out. This is a beautiful, one-of-a-kind place.
Stop on by the Visitor Center at 1215 North State Road 49 in Porter, Indiana, to find a complete list of birding hotspots, a birding checklist, and to request copies of our birding guide.